We, people, live in the world. We try to become better, improved, more advanced, looking at others, listening to what others say, watching what they do, seeking advice. And we think that somehow we will know what we are by doing exactly that. That's not it. To really get to know yourself, you gotta stop chasing the carrots around that keep reappearing as soon as you reach one. You gotta stop, look into yourself, and find out what it is that you are. Hello there! I'm Svetlana Dudarova. Let's introduce last name. This is Subjectivity Approach. If you're new to my channel, to this kind of information, the root of it is the reason is in me. Whatever is happening around me, around you, is a replica, so to speak, of a condition of your mind. It's perfect instrument if you are looking for a way to get to know yourself better. I call it repaint your Dorian Gray's you are portrait. Repaint, not just look at it. When something happens to you, you already have accepted that it's your reflection. Situation, people acting weird, that's something for you to understand. It's the data that came to you. You just need to process it, understand how, why it's in your reality, in your world. That's your desires. Somewhere deep inside your desires, you want something without knowing it. Otherwise, you probably want it different because you don't want to have a disease. You don't want to get into abusive situations, right? If you do, that means that you just don't realize yet what you really want because you simply just didn't see it somewhere in the background. I guess subconscious mind, you can call it consciousness as software, and on the background there are services, all of the tasks running on the background. We don't know, they just somewhere. As soon as we realize and see blind spot, see, it's about the same thing. We realize and we already can see, I want it differently. I don't want it through abusive situation. I don't want get feeling of appreciation by creating this distorted model. It has been created somewhere in the past. It worked out. It got me out of some kind of situation in the past. And I, by default, I continue living from that model somewhere in the back. See? Just because my brain marked somewhere on the background that this information, this structure works. That is already outdated. That's why we look into that. We ask, why do I want things like this? You realize what you really want, knowing that you want that. This is how it happens, simply because your brain somehow, somewhere has this data outdated. So you ask, how can I make it differently? So how does it apply to knowing yourself? This is where you begin to listen to yourself. You don't turn to other people and ask them what to do. You can ask for information. You ask a question and they give you information and you listen and you know, okay, this is for me to understand. Otherwise, if it's not for you, you wouldn't hear it. Everything happens for you in your world. You hear that and you have a piece of the puzzle, right? And you have something else that you've gathered from around. And you already can think, okay, so this, this and that, all of this I see that my desire is, as I said, for example, the feeling of appreciation. We think that it has to be coming from the outside world, right? That's why we keep searching for approval and all of this. But if you ask, what do you really want? What is this feeling of appreciation? It's simply a joy knowing that what you do is needed by the world, which if you look bigger, zoom out, it's by default. If you are alive still, it means you want to live and you have something to give the world, something that only you can. Otherwise, you wouldn't want to live, you would be dead already. So you, it's already by default, but we, someone in the background, we think that yes, all of this we need, chase, do career, proof, marketing. I'm so bad at marketing. We think that it's necessary because we have that outdated data on the background from which we keep thinking. And we turn to other people. We try to apply information exactly how it was given to us because it worked for other people, but it worked for them. For you, it's just information. You can apply it as is if it feels right, or you can say, wait a second, if someone said that he felt free by jumping off the building and somehow he landed and survived, it's not gonna mean that you have to go and jump just to have that freedom, right? If someone says LSD is amazing, I'm telling you, LSD feels amazing, but the feeling is identical to what happens to you when you clear your mind completely. When you're at the top, you don't need drugs. You don't. No alcohol is needed, no cigarettes. All you need when you think about that, it's desire of freedom, desire to step away from your brain, to think from your heart, not with this thing, all of this information that everywhere. That's the only reason why drugs work. I mean, sure, our brain again will give us all of the information, chemical, all of this. Yeah, sure, we live in a physical world. Logic of ours will always find some kind of reasoning behind it. But go back to your heart. I don't know. I mean, I can't believe I'm actually using this phrase because that's one of the things my brain wants to know. What is it, open heart? But if you think on the level, not from your brain, but from your soul, I call it panel of control. My center is here as example. And I don't want to fall into the brain and think about solutions and how to do it. I want to be here and realize all of this is happening because I need to understand something. When I do that, I look exactly at myself. No one knows. No one knows what your life is like, what is better for you. Only you, yourself. That's why you look into yourself and ask, why I get what I want like this. And then you look at everyone else, and when you see racism as example, you want to know yourself. Get to know yourself. There you go. You are racist. Yes. If you see it, it means that the model of racism is in your mind, which doesn't mean switch off your brain right now and listen with your center. It doesn't mean bad. It means that this program was introduced to your consciousness, to your mind, to your world, to your vision. And you see it reflected because it's there. If it really drags your attention, if it happens that you are one of the abused ones, you feel it on yourself. You ask yourself, you don't say, oh, that person is horrible, he, she is a racism. No, you ask yourself, okay, I have this freaking racism in my mind. Why? What do I need to understand? And it will be different for everyone. I looked into that. For me, it was darkness and light. For you, it will be different depending where you are, how it is. Meanwhile, all of this shame, guilt, also, it's all brain. It's the concept. You have a feeling. What you have is feelings. And then you named it. Not you, someone, humanity. We named all of these feelings and labeled this is bad because it's draining, which is simply negative, right? A negative sign in mathematics. It doesn't give you, it takes from you. Not bad or good. There is no such thing. It doesn't exist. It's just is. And positive, happiness, joy, all of that beautiful things. That's plus because it fulfills you. It brings you up. Ask yourself, into yourself, what do I see? And why is it in a shape, in a form that drains me, that empties me? And you go to the very center. It might feel at first, if you are at the beginning of your transition, it might feel painful sometimes because all of this, all the structures kick in, all of these concepts, we feel pain. Go through. If you patch consciousness, I'll include the link, patch it, heal it. Just going through straight to your depth. Why you have this something? Why is it through? What exactly is, what desire is behind it? You will be so surprised. It all comes to one, two, three little things. I want to love, I want to express myself, my true, real self, without shame, without all of this fluff. That's why you go through it, because, I mean, if you patch, it just dissolves, it removes the feeling completely. Because, I mean, it takes 2 seconds as soon as you recognize it. And then right away you can see, because normally we react to it, we pull away right away because we don't like to be, or we begin to cry and then we go even deeper. It's like, poof, right away, you just straight to the bottom of your ocean of your mind. But remove it, clear your mind, all of these are filters, and you see right away that it's a simple desire, very beautiful desire, like racism. It's desire of acceptance. Acceptance equals love. On whichever side you are, it's simply desire to accept everything. As soon as you realize it, it just disappears. I mean, there will be different many hooks attached to it, right? A lot of entangled stuff. Begin looking at it. I'm using this as example. You use your own situation or wherever thing you are learning about yourself. And don't beat yourself up or blame or anything. It's fluff. It doesn't exist. It exists because you have that form somewhere in your mind, in your consciousness. And it's attached to things. It's like, that's why I call it entangled. It begins reacting only because it's attached. As soon as you remove this thing, the attachment, it stops vibrating and you finally, you stop dragging your attention there and you can see what is in front of you. Look at it. What desire is there? That's your desire. That's how you get to know yourself. You learn about your desires without being scared to look into that, because it's nothing scary. When you think about why is my child dying, it's scary to think, oh yes, for some reason I want it, when you begin doing it. But there is nothing. You just find it. You want to be happy. And like this, you waste your attention there. You spend your time, you spend your energy, instead of doing your own thing, thinking about how to make yourself happy, how to create, give the world what you came here for. Instead of that, you're telling your son, oh, you got to be smart, you got to study, you got to be good, respect women, lose virginity not earlier than such and such age. Why? Your child is beautiful, it's love, it's your creation, it's exact replica of your soul, what your child is doing. It's like your inner child, if you're from spiritual community, you know what I mean. But look at it like this. Child is dying because you want to get your attention here. So everything that doesn't let you, cut, patch, change desire. How can I do this without son dying? By understanding, for example, that son is a separate human being, son, daughter, who also came here for his, her own project. And you coexist together, mirroring, reflecting for each other, living together in peace, coexisting, co-creating your reality together. And you do your own thing. Person does his or her own thing and you live together. It comes with relationship, same thing. You don't need to break up. Just understand why. How can you be together without putting everything you got into that person? Compromises and all that crap. That's crap! Compromise what? Your happiness? You're here for the sole purpose, to be happy. Because from happiness, I have a video. From happiness, you can do anything. It's the sole thing to be here. To be on top, sometimes maybe for fun. I don't know if you are into extreme stuff. Well, your brain is used to it. Sometimes go get some information to process something new. And again, live. Shine on yourself and others who is also just like you. When you know yourself, when you know what you want, and if you don't get what you want, looking into that and finding out what it is and how you want it, you get to know yourself so well. You realize that everything around yourself is you as soon as you accept it and stop looking away, pretending that it's not happening, that it's not you. It's you. Yeah. however unpretty it seems at first. There is no bed. Get rid of that and look into that. It's actually beautiful. I'm realizing desire to really get to know yourself is really a desire to experience this moment of complete admiration when you really get to know and see you are amazing. No words, you're amazing. So keep looking into yourself, getting to know your desires and changing them if needed, if they don't match what you want. Adios.
I think I'm going to change my major.
To what?
I don't know yet. What's yours?
I don't even know.
Ah.